Hello everybody, welcome back to Fabioulous Pizza, and today I will tell you something pretty cool. If you're a bit of a geek, I'm sure you will like the concept of baker's percentages. It's a method to calculate the amount of the ingredients we are going to use in our dough in relation to the flour. The idea is we will decide only the amount of flour, while the rest of the doses will come by consequence. This method allows us to move from the concept of recipe, which might be a bit limiting in a way, to the concept of formula. And this is cool because it has several advantages, but I will tell you in a moment. First, I need to tell you how baker's percentages actually work. To explain, I will use the doses of my own recipe. They come from my dough calculator, which you will find in the description of this video. Here are the doses. Like I said, we compare everything to the flour and we express it in percentage. In this case, these 160 grams of flour represent our starting 100%. Then we have 100 grams of water. Let's see the baker's percentage now. We divide the amount of water by the amount of flour. It's 0.625 in our case. But we're looking for a percentage here, therefore we had to multiply the result by 100, and it's 62.5%. I hope I've explained it well enough. Please leave me a comment if there's anything not clear. It would be important for me to get a feedback in order to improve in the future, maybe do a better version of this video. But let me continue calculating the two missing ingredients, salt and yeast. I gave volumetric measures here because they are so tiny, and although I always recommend getting a cheap kitchen scale, you know, they can hardly measure very small amount. By the way, for the sake of our example and explanation, let's say we use 5 grams of salt and 1.6 grams of dry yeast. They are not random numbers, rather they are very close approximation, and you will know it when you will use this precision scale. Let's calculate the percentages. 5 grams of salt divided by 160 grams of flour times 100. Then 1.6 grams of dry yeast divided again by 160 grams of flour times 100. See, we have turned a recipe into a formula to make our dough. We will use 160 grams of flour, 62.5% water, 3% salt, 1% dry yeast. Yay, thank you very much. I made it, I can go now. Now, before I highlight the advantages of using baker's percentages, if you like what you're seeing, please give me a thumbs up so maybe YouTube will push this video to more curious, geeky pizza lovers like you and me. So, advantages. First, this method gives us the ability to scale our doses up or down. Let's say I want to make a bigger pizza. Those 160 grams of flour are not enough for me, because I'm a hungry boy. I want to use 200 grams of flour. Let's just calculate the amounts of the other ingredients using baker's percentages. The percentages will stay the same, of course, only the amounts will change. So water will be still 62.5% calculated on 200 grams of flour, the new measure. And this equals 125 grams of water. The same way you had to calculate 3% salt, that is 6 grams, and 1% yeast, that is 2 grams. Important, you can also do your calculation starting from the whole dough, the yield. But I will skip this part because I don't want to make this video too long. Maybe you would consider booking a session with me. Check out the description of the video. Another advantage of baker's percentages is that you are using a standard. You and the other bakers and pizza lovers in particular will speak the same language. It will be easier to understand each other, to share what to do or to share your experiments, etc. And finally, you will be able to predict somehow what kind of product you will bake in the end. For example, the traditional Neapolitan pizza, which you probably know, usually contains around 62-63% water and 3% salt, and up to around 2% of fresh yeast. These are basically the doses on my calculator when you use plain flour. But if you set it for bread flour, the water percentage would be higher, around 66%. And this reminds me, I need to mention hydration before we conclude today's video. Hydration, the thing that everybody talks about, is none other than a baker's percentage. It's the percentage of water in our dough in relation to the flour. For example, when I mentioned Neapolitan pizza, I said it has 62-63% water, and that's exactly the hydration. But please remember this, it's important. Hydration says how much the flour is hydrating. That number we say does not refer to the whole dough. I know we all use it in that sense, I do it as well, because it's common language, you know, but you need to be aware that the percentage we're talking about refers to the flour only. If you made it so far, congratulations, you're now officially a pizza geek.